Hello guys, Igor here for one more AppSumo review. Today analyzing Adscook, a comprehensive automation and analytics for Facebook and Instagram ad campaigns. Adscook is a Facebook and Instagram ads management platform that lets you launch and scale campaign across multiple accounts with customizable monitoring tool. It's an alternative to Smartly EO and Reveal Bot. This is a kind of a rare tool to come on AppSumo and as a lifetime deal because it's such a technical tool and needs to be always updated with the new Facebook and Instagram regulations. So it's pretty rare to find a tool like Adscook on AppSumo. And right now, we are going to test it to see if it's a good option and a good alternative to ReveilBot. Remembering that ReveilBot was one time on AppSumo as a lifetime deal, long time ago. And since now, Adscook is the first one that will try to do the same features than ReveilBot. And as you can see here, we have different kind of tiers, tier 1, tier 2, tier 3, and the difference is only the monthly ad spend limit. If you're going to spend up to $15,000 per month, just go to the tier 1. If you need to spend more dollars per month, you can go up to tier 3 to get $100,000 per month spending on ads. So let's take a look at their features. Let's see how the tool works. As you can see here, this is the main dashboard. I just signed to a trial version. And the first thing that you do when you log in on Adscook is connecting your ads account. So you need to have a Facebook ads account to use Adscook. And you can see that on the dashboard, you have some analytics here about the impressions of your ads and the spend. So how much you spent and how many impressions you did have. And here there are some steps that you got on their analytics as well. The number of clicks you got, the number of links you got, number of times your content was viewed, added to cart, and also the purchase. And here on below, you're going to see your campaigns with impressions, clicks, reach, spent, ROAS, revenue, impressions, CTR, etc. This works to use on Instagram and also Facebook. And everything works using those tabs here, dashboard, audience, ad assets, and automation. So you did install your account and you're going to see your page here. As you can see here, the page on your Facebook account, and you see your Facebook page, and also you can use the Instagram page. And here on the left, you're going to create a new audience on the second tab on the left. You click here to create a new audience, and let's see the kind of customizations that they have. What you can do to create a new audience, okay? So you can change the location, so segment the audience by location. So for instance, on Brazil, or even on France, you can just target people on France, and you can select the language. So people who speak English, people who speak German, who speak Spanish. Here, for instance, I'm targeting people who speaks English or is Spanish in the United States. You can see here, it's pretty easy to understand the dashboard. It is just like showing to be a good deal. And you can see here on the right, your estimated audience size. When I change anything here on the right, you're going to see your estimated audience size. And then you can target the age, for instance, from 20, here's 19, from 20 to 35. Okay, you can use 8B examples and select two ranges, okay, to test different audiences. Okay, to test different audiences per segment, language, location, age, and then you can select also gender. Let's say for your product, you only want to target female. You can see here that changes the audience as well. And then here you will detail your target, choosing values from interest, demographics, behavior, and custom audience. You can also save presets, so save detailing target, for instance, to use on other audience. So let's see here. So I want to target people who has interest in law. So in privacy law, in refugee law, paternity law, medical law, animal law. Let's see that they like the law society. So all this law is good for me. And I just select those interested. So I'm going to target people who like those interests. So you can change and select this as well. You can also exclude some interest or even narrow the interest. Narrow the people that like privacy law and, for instance, common law. And excluding, for instance, I don't want people who are interested in criminal law. So criminal law, criminal lawyer, I'm excluding them. Okay, so you can also use your lookalike audience from Facebook and customizing even more. So it's possible to use lookalike audience on Adscook. The placement manual. Then you're going to select which places you want. If only on desktop, if only on mobile, you can select here. If you want to target Instagram or not, you just click on manual to select which ones you want to run your ad. So if you don't want Instagram, for instance, you just turn it then all off. Okay. But if you want that placement to be automatic, just click here and it's automatic. You can find your audience easier adding tags, for instance, a law tag here. So then when I'm searching for audience related to law on Adscook, I just add my tag law and I can find the audience that I've created. I have my estimated audience size here on the right, and then you just click on save and you have a whole new audience on the tool with your tag. Pretty cool. I'm liking that tool. I'm liking Adscook. And here you create your ad asset. So you can create ad assets here and save. And how each one works. So first you're going to select your page. So let's say I want to select that page here, the new law. Okay, with that Instagram, new law. And then you can select your ad types. Those are the ad types. A link ad. So I'm going to add a link. A photo ad. You're going to add a photo. A video ad, you can add a video here or choose from Google Drive. You can add a slideshow video, a carousel. A carousel can be using image, videos, or a slideshow, an app ad, or a lead ad. Okay, those are the different kind of ads that they have. For the sake of that review, let's select the link ads. So the link ads, you're gonna add a website ad. You add a website URL, your ad text. I'm testing Adscook. Adscook is awesome. The link that you want to display on your ads, link descriptions, and your call to action as on Facebook. You can add shop now, see menu, sign up, book now, download. So your call to action. Let's check to learn more. You can create a tag to your ad asset as well. And then let's add a photo, or you can add from your Google Drive to create your ads. I'm just adding a random photo here. So here I just selected everything, and then I have a new ad asset to use on my campaigns. Here, the ad asset here, you can view it here. Here it is. my ad assets related to the accounts that I choose. Everything is well organized on the dashboard. I think we have a winner here on Adscook. And the other feature is the automation features, where you can create automations. And then with those automations, you add rules. And then if your ad is not going well, you can just stop automatically the ad and also kind of rules. For instance, your ad is doing so well, so then you just will, you know, spend more money to sell more using your ads. So let's say you want to pause your ads if you're not getting conversions, and then you can use the rules. You can create a rule from scratch, or you can use their own strategies. Look how Adscook is cool. So you can pause your ads if it's not, they are not converting. So click here to pause your ads if they are not converting. You can see here that on that template, they already have the conditions, spent last 3 days plus 50 reels in that case. Purchase at set last 3 days is zero. So when I spent in 3 days more than 50 reels and I do not sell anything, the ad will stop immediately. Okay. And then you can select the campaign where you're going to use those rules. You can select a date to run your rule, or you can add it continually. Okay. So here is a rule. You just need to assign that rule to a new item. Okay. And here on the blue button is where you're going to create your campaign. So are you aiming conversion, traffic, post engagement, video view, lead generation, paid likes, for instance, traffic. If you're going to select your ads account, your destinations, if your website, you're going to choose your budget, if daily or lifetime, select all the features that you usually do. You're going to select the audience that you already create. For instance, you're going to click on next. Then you can select your ad asset or create a new asset here. For instance, if I want to select that ad, it's just created and it's done. And then in the end, you're going to publish your ad. As you can see here, the tool is pretty much complete. I think I'm going to buy that one. I think it's complete. I think it can help me a lot with my Facebook ads. Since ReveilBot, we do not see a tool like that. So I think it's awesome. I think it's a winner. I hope you like that review. See you next time.